We never scheduled a meeting.
You have to see that all as well.
I think all as well.
You can tell me about it between now and 6:00. All right, I'm good.
Okay. All right, let's go back to paper number 19, which has been moved to the regular agenda. Mr. Tom, please, it's your paper. You're going to continue it? Okay.
What page?
Number 19. And Mrs. Daniels, you have a paper also, number 33. On the regular agenda.
19.
Yes.
I think probably this is a good idea. Do you want to leave it on the regular agenda?
I'm just happy to move into consent if it's easier, but the key thing is explaining to people that as a body, we are opposed to holding.
And I believe that PDC, both the PDC and also Urban Crescent really have both requested not halls, but to have the gas packs.
And there's a long list of other jurisdictions, Central Virginia and Southeastern Virginia, who have also passed resolutions opposing this and support the true solidarity with workforce long-term instead of quick fix.
I would like to be a co-patron. Is there anyone else that would like to co-patron? This paper expresses our opposition to the proposed Virginia Department of Transportation plan to toll and state limit bus. The paper says, we don't think tolls should be the way you're raising money to pay for road use. So is there anyone else that would like to co-patron? I'd like us all to co-patron if possible.
To give you an idea, Lieutenant Fisher, the Greensville County Board of Supervisors, Chairman Peyton Wiley, Victoria Mayor Smith, Assistant County Board Supervisor, Chairman Bruce Tyler, and then as well as Lieutenant Fisher from Wakefield, Stony Creek, Petersburg, Ashland, Dumfries, Jarrett, Hanover, Denny, Chesterfield, Waverly, Spotsylvania, Princeport, and Hope, Alabama.
All right, is there anyone else that would like to co-patron on this?
No, President.
Yes, sir.
Nobody likes tolls. Nobody likes tolls. But we also know that we've got to come up with a fix. And I haven't heard any later renditions of a fix.
Actually, Senator Watkins has a fix in, and it involves gas tax.
It does. Nobody likes tax.
Actually.
Nobody likes tax. So then we're going to have a fight over taxes. We got to fix the road, though. So I'm going to stay out of this.
Okay.
Let them fight it out upstairs.
All right, yeah, Mr. Connor, myself, go.
Madam President.
Yes, sir.
I will co-patron that.
Thank you, Mr. Connor.
No problem.
Appreciate that. Ms. Robinson?
Yes.
Okay, Ms. Robinson, also. And now, Mr. Clark, I believe we need to go back to number 6 to get an answer from Mr. Daniels.
Madam President.
Yes, sir.
We have an answer. The answer is the 1.9 that I referenced was an estimate. This is the hard number. So the 1.9 is encompassed within this 4.4 group.
You pay for number 6.
You ordered just the paper.
I don't think I am.
No.
I'm sorry. I have paper 6, 2012-199, yes. When we had the big school budget issue, we realized that the state was going to allocate what we thought at that point was, I think, 1.9 million extra. It turns out they are allocating 4.4 million. That's what.
So it's $8.
It's still $8. My question was, is this in addition to the 1.9 or
on secure schools and the residents. Opportunities for the city. Ms. Marshall, is everybody here that needs to be here? If we have questions, is anybody, is everybody here that needs to answer questions? We're getting ready to do the papers. Okay. I'm all ready, Mr. Marshall, Ms. Travel, you wanted to bring up something about the council procedure?
Thank you.